son, and she could call him Jesus. The angel appeared to Mary before she got married. She is engaged to Joseph. Joseph, an ordinary carpenter. At first, Mary was afraid and troubled by the angel's words. Being a virgin, Mary questioned the angel. How would this be? At times, it is not a bad thing to question, but how you carry out the question. Amen?
Amen.
The angel explained that the child will be God's own child, and therefore, nothing is impossible to God. There is nothing impossible to God. There is nothing God cannot do. Even in an awkward situation, God can make it an awesome one. Amen?
Amen.
Humble and in awesomeness, Mary believed. Humble. If you are a Christian, you don't have that humble heart. You don't humble. My dear, you're wasting your time, because God knows that we have sinned. He said it by himself. He said we have sinned and fall short of his glory. But with obedience, that is why he sent his son to die for us. That is why he sent him today to be born, so that he know us, so that he come to live with us. Amen?
Amen.
Mary's fear did not let him disobey God. Instead, he rejoiced in the Lord because of the message he received from the angel. Amen?
Amen.
Surely, Mary reflects with wonder on the words found in Isaiah 7, verse 14. Foretelling this event, therefore the Lord himself will give a sign. The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son and will call him Emmanuel. That is Isaiah 7, verse 14. Jesus' birth has been prophesied since then, because God knows that we, as human beings, we need him down here. He has to make a way for him to be down here, to see our struggles, to see our pain. Amen? Can somebody read for me Matthew 1, verses 18 to 25.
This is how the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph, but before they came together, she was found to be pregnant through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, who was faithful to the law, and yet did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly.
Okay, hold it right there. Whilst Mary was still engaged to Joseph, the Jewish law, you can be engaged, you do things common as husband and wife, but sexually, it was not permitted. Amen?
Amen.
Now, Mary has engaged to Joseph. Now, he's coming to tell Joseph that, I am pregnant. If your wife just come in and say, hey, I am pregnant, you know you never judge that wife, what will you feel? You feel bad, right? That is the same feeling that Joseph felt when Mary told him about his pregnancy. Amen?
Amen?
When Mary told Joseph she was pregnant, he had a right to feel disgraced. Feel disgraced. Am I not a man that I will see somebody that I'm engaged, somebody pregnated that person? Those are the thoughts that was with Joseph. Thinking all that, where was I when this happened? Go on.
But after he drew, said Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
Okay, hold on there. What her vision for Joseph and even Mary? Because she knew, nobody can tell, but she knew she was still a virgin. So no explanation can see her. except the grace of God. Because God knew what was going on with her. And God that knows what was going on, he will make a way that nothing like stoning and everything will happen to Mary. And Joseph, because of his faithfulness, God will make a way for him to understand what is going on. Amen?
Amen.
Joseph not only had the right to divorce Mary, according to the Jewish law, he has the right to divorce her. But what did he choose? He chose to divorce her secretly. That means they can still be out there giving the impression that we're still engaged, we're still wives, right? She's still my wife. But he will not have nothing to do with her sexually. This is the secret that he's keeping. Because of why? He don't want Mary to be to continue to go for the public disgrace. And which will cause him life, her life. Because in the end they will stone her. If Joseph said, that pregnancy is not mine, definitely they're going to stone her to death. Amen?
Amen.
Go on.
All this is through the prophet. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call you Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he did not consummate their pregnancy until she gave birth to a son.
Action first was Jimmy was thinking he has two options. Either I divorce her secretly, or I announce that, hey, this lady, I don't know where this pregnancy is coming from. And what would be the consequence for Mary? They will stone her to death. What will Joseph be profiting from there? From her being stoned to death. So he chose to divorce her secretly. But God has another plan. That is why as we Christians, we should not listen at times to our own decision, our plans. Because God's plan is the best. God's time is the best. Whilst Joseph was planning to divorce her secretly, God was planning for him to go further with the engagement and marry her. So at times we should not consider our own selfishness. As a Christian, we should not consider it. We should pray to God for God to direct us to take the right decision in decision making. Now God instructs Joseph. He said, go and take that woman to be your wife. What he is carrying is of mine. Amen?
Amen.
Although Joseph initially in reaction was to break the engagement, which is an appropriate thing to do as a righteous man, because the woman has become pregnant, not by him. So is it not legal to divorce her?
Yeah.
It is. But he said, let me listen to God, because he's a righteous man. And even that, he still considered to treat Mary with kindness. Men that are here today, whether you are little, learn from this. We ladies, we need gentlemen, we need people that hears and treats us. Even when we are wrong, we need to be pampered. Amen?
Amen.
So please, today, I want you man to know that you have to pamper us. Amen?
Amen.
He did not want to cause further shame, so he decided to divorce her quietly. But God sent an angel to Joseph in a dream to verify Mary's story. That means Mary will not tell him, the husband. Say, Pa, don't get belle. But Mr. Seth will not say this belle for God. He will not say, Come on, I will say no more. I will say no more open tonight. But hey, God is in control. God is able, abundantly able, to do anything without question. Amen?
Amen.
Joseph, in a dream, to verify Mary's story, and resume and reassure him that his marriage to her was God's will. As Christian, we should always sing God's will. Even in an awkward situation, if the God said and will, go ahead and do it. God that has ordained, God that has said, go, he will make a way. God that said, do it, he will always bring a positive result in us all.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
God is good.
The angel explained that the child within Mary was conceived by the Holy Spirit, that his name should be Jesus, and that he was the Messiah, God with us. Amen. This is the significance of Jesus being with us.
Amen.
You know, we get one saying. We say, sin is believing. And at times we'll be saying, if you don't see those thoughts, you don't even see. God knows us before even we are formed.
Yes.
He knows our attitude. He knows. Because even the one that used to be with him, the disciple, Thomas, he denied Jesus. He said, but before ever go believe, say, now you, I never see who said they pierced you.
Amen.
Before I go know, say, now you, I never see the foot who said they be there. Because God knows us. He sent Jesus, who is God, who is himself, to come and dwell among us, so that at least he will know us. He will know our character. He will know our weakness. He will know our strength. So that right now, as he's sitting in the throne, when we do wrong here, we say, but don't forget, not let woman, I'll be more to get. Do you miss again? So we should be grateful to God that he sent his only begotten son to be born and die for us. Amen?
Amen.
When Joseph woke up from his dream, he willingly obeyed God. Obedient. As Christian, we should obey. If we don't obey with authorities, we don't obey people that are standing here, are we going to obey God?
No.
No. Because these people are representative of God. If we don't believe of them, if we don't trust them, we are wasting our time. Just like what the pastor just said. We are looking for powerful men of God. You are wasting your time. If any man is boasting of his power, check that power. It's not of God.
Amen.
The only powerful man is Jesus.
Amen.
Yes.
We are all servants. That is why we should humble ourselves. Even we, the pastors. If we don't humble ourselves, question that pastor. Because Jesus showed us many examples of humility. He washed his disciples' feet. He forgave those that even beat and pierced him. So if a man of God don't have those character, check. It's not about perfection. It's about your sincerity. Amen?
Amen.
He willingly obeyed God and took Mary home to be his wife in spite of the public humility he had faced. You know, what in them two in the face is, they don't broke the law, the Jewish tradition. You will not have sex when you are not married. They just engage. So you know how much they talk about them in the town. How much they say, oh, Joseph don't break the law. Joseph and Mary, they don't do this. Now they're pregnant, they are not married. But Joseph did not look to human saying, he looked at what God is saying. If you are here today, not listening to what people are saying, I'm telling you, you will never do the right thing. Let me give you a story. There was this man and his son. They were traveling those days. They traveled with donkeys. They have only one donkey. They have some glow. The whole man was on top of the donkey with some of the items. The boy was moving. They went to the first village. They said, this man is very wicked. Look at his son walking, and he's on top of there. This man is a witch. He's wicked. The man just, the end of the village, he said, okay, well, you come up the donkey, then you can ride. The second village, they said, you see how now they're speaking in town? In Papa, the water, in the car like Papa, they're on top. Lord have mercy, this is wicked. This is one of the fair blessing. This is exactly how we do, how we human beings are. No matter what you do, they criticize. No matter what you say, they have negative things to do. As children of God, today, I urge you, stop listening to people. Listen to God. If you pay attention, you listen to God. God is talking to you right now.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Joseph never listened to all those things. Perhaps because of his noble quality, this is the reason why God chose him to be the heavenly father.
Amen.
Because even when Jesus grown up, they are still talking. When even he's doing good, they say, no manner. that carpenter's son. What did he mind? You can call me any name. I don't care. The name God gave me is the best for me. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Joshua 2 he had wondered. And remember the saying, when God they do something, he will always do things for make improvement. Because of Joseph said, we don't read Isaiah. He knows that God will not prophesy this to them, right? That Isaiah. In what does they not go too far? He accepts immediately. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why is the virgin? The virgin birth is so important in the Christian faith. Why? I want the congregation to involve now. Why is the virgin birth so important? Why is this so significant in the Christian lives? I want the answer from the congregation. What I want to hear. Sins.
Yeah.
Before Christ, God destroyed. And God hates to destroy what he made.
Yeah.
He looked at it. He said, you know what? I have to do things. Because these people will continue to sin. I have to send my own self, my own son, to come and mingle with them. To know them. So that when he come back to me, he will be in the throne to plead on their behalf. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus Christ, son, God's son, had to be free from the sinful nature passed onto us through Adam. If you would get sin, how you were able to free people from sin? This is the reason why the Virgin Mary conceived from no man. You look at the sin and then man and they create sin, they perpetrate. Because Jesus was born through a woman, he's sinless. The man won't mix it. So, therefore, check on our pastor. Amen?
Amen.
Because Jesus was born of a woman, he was a human being. But as the Son of God, Jesus was born without any trace of human sin. Jesus is both fully human and divine spirit. Divine spirit. Not ordinary spirit, but a divine one. Amen?
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
God loves us.
Amen.
Because Jesus lived as a man, he knows that he fully understands our experiences and struggles. Somebody turn to Hebrews 4, 15 to 16. Somebody read it for me, please. Hebrews. Hebrews 4, 15. Hebrews 4:15. Can somebody read it or I'll read it? For we do not have a high priest who is unable to sympathize with our weakness.
Amen.
Our high priest can sympathize with our weakness. He knows our weakness. So if somebody knows what you're going through, he will sympathize with it. That is why Jesus is here. Amen?
Amen.
But we have one who has been tempted in every way, just as we are, yet was without sin. All of us here have been tempted in one way or the other. We yield to temptation. But Jesus never, for us to know that he is a clean man, for us to know that he is a righteous man, for us to know that he came to save us, for us to know that he came to redeem us, he made himself perfect. Because if you don't make himself perfect, people say, "Obi Alego Mia." You know, can't tell me, but this one you don't know that. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He facing trials, but still, he never yielded to those temptations. Amen.
Amen.
Because he is God, he has the power and authority to deliver us from sins. Colossians 2. 13 Colossians 2, yes.
Starting
from verse 13.
When you were dead, sinful nature, God made you alive.
Amen.
With Christ.
Hallelujah.
He forgave us all our sins. Mm-hmm. Having canceled the written code with its regulations that was against us and that stood opposed to us, mm-hmm. He took it away, nailed it to the cross. Verse 15. And having disarmed the powers and authorities, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them by the cross.
We are sinners. We sin in words, in thoughts. There are demonic forces that are after us. Satan is right there. Whatever we do good, he say, no, you're not right. We do bad, he pamper us. That is why Jesus came. To take away our sins. For what he did at the cross. He made those sins. As children of God. We are free from sins.
Amen.
All we need to do is. We believe. We trust. We lean on him. We depend on his words. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus Christ has done it all for us.
Amen.
We can tell Jesus all our thoughts, feelings and deeds. He has been there. When it has been where we are now, where somebody is on side, you can tell her everything. You know, even when we left Africa, when we tired, we were born in Africa. When they tell me, we know what they want, they pass the one they were born in, we are Africans. So this is it. Jesus knows our weakness. Jesus knows our struggles. He will care at the end of the day. That is why he came. That is why he's up there right now interceding to his Father to see that sin will not hold us captive. Amen?
Amen.
As children of God, how are we going to tell Jesus our feeling, our need? Are we just going to say, hey, Papa, me, I have a problem to you? The word of God, the prayer. He said, we are two or three together. We will be there at times. If you need, call somebody, come here. Pray. Then Jesus will hear your problems. Jesus will hear you. And Jesus will do the right thing for you. Amen?
Amen.
Joseph was forced with difficulties in choosing after discovering the pregnancy. But he did the right thing. Amen?
Amen.
He did the right thing because he trusts God. Because he knows the God is serving. Will not give him any load that he cannot carry. Amen?
Amen.
So he obeyed. He obeyed. In view of that, of this circumstance, this had not occurred to Joseph. But God often shows us that there are many options than we can think. Joseph was just thinking about one option. I will divorce him quietly, since I've already said, I will not let them stone him. But God said, no, divorce is not my option. You're going to marry her because I am fulfilling my purpose.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen?
So Joseph think that, oh, since God has talked, God says this, who am I to say no? Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good. All the time. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Yet Joseph chose to obey the angel's command. When our decision affects the life of others, we must always seek God's wisdom and be willing to follow through, no matter how difficult it may be. No matter how difficult it may be, we should learn to listen to God. If anything that we do will affect the next person, think about it before you do it. Because Joseph knew, if he said, no, this pregnancy is not mine, it's going to affect me, he think twice. As Christian, let us not enjoy others' suffering. Let us not enjoy others' crying. Let us always be there for them. Let us only tell, even when somebody hurts you. At times they do things. My husband always say, oh, you don't know what they do. And at times it's true. People will do things, they don't know what they're doing. If Jesus looked at all those people, look at the journey he go with the cross. Nobody realized that what he's doing is wrong. Till they bring him to the cross and they nail that man. Not a criminal. They crucify him like a criminal. But still, he said, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing. At times, the Lord just don't look at the negative because of we are suffering, because of the pain we are going through. Let us look at what our Lord Jesus has done for us. Amen?
Amen.
Jesus Christ, he came to redeem us. Jesus Christ, he came because he loves us. Amen?
Amen?
The conception and birth of Christ as supernatural, a supernatural event beyond human logic and reason. Because of this, God sent angels to help certain people considering the significance of what was happening. Always, when God do things beyond human, we started thinking. But if we believe God, we don't have to think. Why? Because God even give us an example. Is this sheep? Is the sheep not goat, right? That will, sheep, no man, no man, the sheep will still conceive and have children. Who think he's doing that? It is God. So if God can do that, why are we doubting that the supernatural birth of Christ is a very significant one? And whenever God do something in those kind of situations we are in, at times decision is difficult. At times where to turn is difficult. He will send angels. He will send dream. At times he will send people from nowhere. Just come and just tell you right there what to do. So that is exactly what he's doing in this birth of Christ. He told Mary through an angel. Joseph through an angel. So as children of God, we should not ignore the voice of God. We should not ignore the voice of God. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God is good. All the time. God is awesome. God is awesome. God is awesome. Amen. This reveals an important truth about Jesus. He is both God and human. The infinite, unlimited God.
Amen.
Took on the limitations of humanity so he could live and die for our salvation. As Christians, we should not be unlimited. We should have that God. Don't have no limitation. We should not, just like our Bible study today, even if it takes 7 years, how many years do the people be in the wilderness? But God is still going to fulfill his promise.
Amen.
My sister, keep praying for that vow that you've made.
Amen.
The God that you're serving is a living God. He will surprise you.
Amen.
One day he will surprise you. Amen?
Amen.
God is good. God will surprise you even when you don't ask. When I was in Guinea, struggling after the war has dealt with us, me and my children, we jumped a fence like this. I was having reggae on my back, mommy on my hand, and a bag of gari, running for survival. I jumped a, or just like this. I don't know how I go up there with my children. And let me tell you, we survived. No broken, no leg, no nothing. 3 days we are lying on the floor. 3 days we are lying on the floor. You see, they are bombarding the glass window. I'm coming down. The only person that can speak and eat there is this lady. She will say, mommy, can't go down. You know the eat? The dry gari. She was chewing that gari. She's the only one that eat that day, those 3 days. But still, we are alive today.
Amen.
Why? It is because of not our power, not our might. It is because of the grace of God.
Yeah.
You think I jumped that fence? No. God just manipulated it and just sent me and my children there for safety reason. So God, if we trust in him, we'll tell him our problem. He will. We flew from Syria. We went to Conakry again. They fight for us. They said, you know what? Your family never went through. So all of us should go back to Sierra Leone. My kids are in school at the middle of the year. When God is doing things, this is the reason why Jesus came to us. Even when that time I was not a believer. But still, he knew he has a purpose for me.
Mm-hmm.
everybody left in Conakry. I said, I'm not going to take my kids from school. At the end of the term, we'll travel. I said, because if we go now to Sierra Leone, they will miss school. I was there. I have this friend of mine. He came to my house 3 times. He said, oh, I'm hearing they call a name. I said, no, it is not my name. I said, our finding, they disqualified it. He came the second day. The third day he came. Early in the morning, I was preparing my kids to school. He said, you will go today with me. I said, well, if you decided to go with me, then you have to wait. I have to take my kids to school, come clean my house, and take a shower. He said, no matter how it costs me today, I'll drag you to that office. May God bless her.
Amen.
She did drag me. I made all reluctant. She was at home. I dressed my kids. I took them to Trust International. Came back home. She's still behind me. We went there. They've called all the names. I said, why did you bring me? He said, well, then we'll call back. And immediately they started. The first name they called, Umu Fofana. I was standing there. I did not answer. She answered my name. And then she dragged me to go up that place. All of us that come through the refugee program, you know what I'm talking about. You have to go verify who fight for you and this. I was standing there, she answered, and she was pushing me like that on my own. But God was working for a purpose.
Amen.
This is the purpose Jesus came for.
Amen.
When I went there, who fight for you? I gave everything was match. I said, Father, I thank you. That time is not, my heart was saved. I was just happy that a sinner, a chief sinner like me, that time, I was just happy. I went to call my brother, said, hey, that was the biggest fight we ever had. He said, you think I'm going to send you money? I told you to go. I'm not going to send you money. There is nothing like your name there. I came home broke again. I said, how can this man go? If this is the real woman. Few minutes when I came home, they called. He said, I am so sorry. Really, they just called me. I don't know how it happened. It was a miracle.
Amen.
That is the miraculous way God be talking about the Father we are serving.
Amen.
He will do the impossible in your life.
Amen.
He will do the impossible. He shut my heart. He knows this lady has something that I need.
Yes.
So he make a way when even I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
This is the reason why Jesus was born today. This is the reason. This is the significance of Jesus. Even when you are still sinning, he's still there walking away for you. So my brothers and sisters, no matter what you're going through today, no matter what is your situation today, lift your hand and just say, I know the God I am serving.
Mm-hmm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good.
Amen.
Jesus came to earth to save us because we cannot save ourselves. You think I saved myself with my children on that wall? That's just a half story. If I tell you before we jumped that fence, the RUF, they came, they took us. Monique and the father were under the bed, breaking. They took me and my brother-in-law outside. At that time, if you know the story of Frobe, they killed everybody, fly streets. Our house is, I am the first person that interacts with the rebel without being shot. It is not by my power.
Amen.
He said, what are you doing in Frobe? Because you were looking for me. After interrogating, my brother-in-law said, police money let me them. And I was having money in my, you know, I have those short pants. Well prepared, because we prepare. We share everything to everybody, just in case we get lost. So that this will survive until we get together again. Then my brother-in-law speak timidly. He said, what are you guys doing? He said, we just rent this house. And at that time, when the rebels were interrogating us too, I said, no, if I'm going to die now, at least the ones that in there will survive, because there were 3 of them. The one said, shoot them. The other one said, let them go into the house and burn the house. The other one said, let them give money. And God listened to the one that said, let them give money. All the money that I have, they took it from me. During that process, we keep free from her there and join us from that show. She had so high, my heart was pounding more. It is not by my power. It is not by my making. It is only God's grace that saved us. during that time. That is why God is here. When God is for you, nothing will touch you. You think I have the power? Those that I pass to go over that fence that are there, you think I am better than them? I am the chief sinner among all those of them. But God is not going to look at what we do because he knows we do. He's looking to our heart. He's looking for us to change. He's looking for us to turn around. That is why when you see me dancing, do not think I am crazy.
Amen.
It is the love that he has for me. That is why when he calls his name, I will jubilate. That is why when he calls his name, I will jump. That is why I don't know how to sing, but God bless me with children that can sing. That is why when I'm singing, I don't care what is coming out of my mouth. I care for who is listening to me.
Amen.
God is good. God is awesome. Only Jesus can do this. Jesus did not come to help people. He did not come for us to be helped to save, but he came to save us. When somebody you will help, you can help at any time, right?
Yeah.
You don't even know with all you have, but Jesus never came to help. He came to do it willingly. Regardless of our situation, regardless of who we are, he came to do it because the God, he is God. We are his children. He loved us before even we loved him.
Mm-hmm.
Oh yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good. God is good.
All the time.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good. God is good.
Amen.
Today, I want us to live in this place.
Amen.
To trust nothing but God. To know that God sent his own son. His begotten son, his love done to die today, to be born today, so that he will die in April for me and you to depend on him, for me and you to cast our burden onto him, for me and you to be transformed, to live a new life, to think that all other things is rubbish, but we'll keep pressing.
Amen.
We keep pressing. None of us, including my pastors, we are not perfect. But let us keep practicing. Let us keep pushing and thinking of all those cars, all those clothes. I was looking for this suit. I've had it for many years. You know, my house now is in shambles. I looked all around. I didn't see my clothes. And I want to wear this red thing today. I saw different red. But my spirit said this. And pastor said, Pastor, you know, it's not about the garment. I said, red, yes, really, it's not about the garment. I said, but I just want to be in the spirit today.
Amen.
And then I went to my room to go look for a green. Because usually I like to wear green or thing in that New Year or Christmas. And then I just found it where I've looked over and over. Because God knows I am not wearing it to love.
Hmm.
I just want to wear it to look good for his gospel. Amen.
Amen.
God is good.
Amen.
Let us believe that he came to save us. He came to take away our sins. Amen?
Amen?
Today, I want us to go home with these few names of Jesus. That whenever you reflect on those names, you will know who Jesus is. Whenever you reflect on those names, you will know the significance of Jesus. Whenever you reflect on those names, you will know the importance of Jesus.
Amen.
What is Jesus? Jesus, the Savior.
Amen.
Take it down if you can pass right through.
Amen.
Jesus means the Savior. Christ, the only one anointed by God to redeem us.
Amen.
Emmanuel, God with us.
Amen.
God came to us. You see how love God, if you go to the beginning and say, come, he said, Mama, come. You go say, you don't grace. But Jesus came to us, Emmanuel.
Amen.
Wonderful. The one who does tremendous, wonderful things for us.
Amen.
If we know God's name, if we know God's name, Jehovah Jireh,
amen,
the God of provision.
Amen.
The day spring, the one that brought light to our darkness, hope for a new day.
Amen.
The Prince of Peace, the one who quiets our hearts, calm our spirits, and bring rest,
amen,
to our souls.
Amen.
When you are stressed, when you think everything is lost, just look and say, oh, King of Kings, the Prince of Peace, I need you right now. We will come you.
Amen.
The great counselor, the one who guides our footsteps, lead us on the right path, and speak the love of his Father to our hearts. Today, I want to leave this with you. If you want to know the significance of Jesus, know Jesus' names. These are just few of his names. Know these names. Whenever you are in a calamity, whenever you need joy, just call. This is spring day. This spring, they brought light into our darkness. The Prince of Peace. He brings peace in our life. The Great Counselor. At times he counsels me. So today, I'm going to leave you with these words. That God will continue to work on us. God will continue to lead us into the right path.
Amen.
As he has sent his son today to be born for our sins to be go away. Right now we are free from sins. We are sin free because of him, not because of our ways. If I tell you my own way, you will say she will not stand in this pulpit. Now I'm trying to work on them. But let me tell you something. No one is perfect. No one is a powerful man except him. Amen?
Amen?
Let us pray. Father God in heaven, I just give you the glory. Father, I thank you for those broken words.
Amen.
Oh, Father, I thank you, Father. Father, I will pray that as we have known your names, Father, let us use this name in prayer. Let us use this name in time of joy. Let us use this name in time of struggles, in time of trials. Father, let us use your name so that will help us to know you more.
Amen.
Father, we thank you.
Thank
we
you,
adore you.
Amen.
And this we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.